As of the start of the 2020 season, I have been to all three SeaWorld parks, both Busch Gardens parks, and the Lone Sesame Place park. The SeaWorld chain is home to some fantastic roller coasters. With the rate the chain is expanding, this list is sure to evolve over time, especially with the opening of Iron Gwazi, Pantheon, and Texas Stingray. But today, I wanted to count down my top 10 coasters in the chain. Number 10. Manta at SeaWorld San Diego. Is there a better coaster under 30 feet tall? Manta is just pure fun. It's an extremely re-rideable coaster with multiple pops of airtime and a really forceful helix in the second half. Number 9. Griffin at Busch Gardens Williamsburg. This is my favorite dive machine. It's one of the largest ones to still have the original hard over-the-shoulder restraints that let you fully experience the floater airtime. Griffin is also glass smooth and has a better finale than most dive coasters, with the splashdown and quick pops of airtime. Number 8. Alpengeist at Busch Gardens Williamsburg. Narrowly edging out Griffin is Alpengeist, the monstrous B&M invert. I love Alpengeist's first half. Those gigantic elements really let you feel the ride's speed and power. It's just held back by a slow second half. Number 7. Kumba at Busch Gardens Tampa. Unlike Alpengeist, Kumba delivers from start to finish, and it's one of the most forceful looping coasters on the planet. The zero-G roll in particular stands out, as it's borderline violent how snappy it is. That being said, Kumba does have a bit of a rattle to it, but that's really the only downside. Number 6. Oscar's Wacky Taxi at Sesame Place. Like the other Junior Gravity Group Woodies, Oscar's Wacky Taxi is an airtime machine. The hills are small, but the airtime pops are anything but. The ride is frenetically paced from start to finish, and that's exactly why I love it. Number 5. Cheetah Hunt at Busch Gardens Tampa. Narrowly making the top 5 is this Intamin multi-launch coaster. Cheetah Hunt may not be as forceful as some of the other Intamin coasters out there, but it has several airtime hills and a wonderful setting that makes you feel deep within the jungle. Number 4. Montu at Busch Gardens Tampa. Montu is one of the three best inverts in the world. Outside of the Immelmann, every single inversion is extremely snappy and forceful, even more so than most inverts. The Batwing and the Trench in particular stands out. Number 3. Manta at SeaWorld Orlando. I love B&M Flyers, and Manta is one of the best. It has a really exciting layout. Manta soars over pathways or through beautiful landscaping. And from a ride sensation perspective, Manta juxtaposes the forces of a pretzel loop with the grace of inline twists. Number 2. Mako at SeaWorld Orlando. Apollo's Chariot and Mako really could be flipped, but this ultimately is what I decided on. Mako has some of the strongest and most sustained airtime of any of the B&M hypers in that first half. It is absolutely glorious. The second half, while unique, doesn't quite continue that airtime. Number 1. Apollo's Chariot at Busch Gardens Williamsburg. Apollo's Chariot is an airtime buffet from start to finish, especially if you're in the back row. I won't ride Apollo's Chariot in any other row. Apollo has a great setting deep in the woods. That setting results in some of the best night rides of any coaster. Do you have a favorite coaster in the SeaWorld chain? I'd love to hear your thoughts below. Thanks for listening.